Okay, so I'm going to attempt to show you what are the things that I want to get or what's on my wish list for the Sephora VIB sale that's coming on November 6th to November 9th for us regular VIBs. I believe the VIB Rouge will have earlier access to the sale. So this is my wish list. This is my loves list on the Sephora website. I'm going to start off with the Sephora Favorites Beauty Sleep, which is $30. And I wanted to show you what's inside there. So it comes with the Origins High Potency Nitamins, which I really want to try because I have the Drink Up Intensive and it's awesome. This is half an ounce. Then it also comes with the Ole Henriksen Invigorating Night Treatment Overnight Resurfacer, which is a quarter of an ounce. I have this, I haven't tried it, but I wouldn't really mind having another one. This is the Chorus Wild Rose Plus Vitamin A, or is it Vitamin C? Vitamin C Advanced Brightening Facial Sleeping Mask. I haven't tried this, looking forward to trying that. I've heard so many good things about this. But what really caught my attention on this kit is the Sunday Riley Luna Oil. This is a quarter of an ounce as well. And I've seen so many beauty vloggers here on YouTube talk about this. They say that it gives your skin a little bit of a blue tint, but it disappears right away. And the next day you wake up with the best skin ever. So for $30 and it's $64 value, I think that this is a great way to try all of this products at the same time. So looking forward to using that. The next thing that's on my list is a NARS Audacious lipstick. Now, this list that I'm showing you is a list of things that I either have already tried and would like to repurchase, or would like to repurchase a different shade, or things that I've never tried before and would like to take full advantage of the 20% off that they're offering for the fall VIB sale in order to get my hands on these. There are also some products on here that I have already bought and could not wait for the VIB sale to happen because I was afraid that it was going to sell out. So I'm going to talk to you about that as well. Now, the NARS Audacious lipsticks have very good opacity. They wear very, very well. They're very comfortable on the lips and I love them. So I wouldn't really mind owning another one. The one that I have right now is the color called Vanessa. And I believe that was only available in the NARS website last year. The one that I'm showing here right now is called Jane, which is a terracotta rose, which I feel is perfect for the fall and winter. So I'm looking at getting that. One that I am definitely going to get, if you can see there's a theme here, I do love my skincare. Is the Sephora Collection Sleeping Mask Discovery Set. Now, Sephora products are underrated for some reason, but they really have very good ones. This come with 6 of the 8 mL face masks in various, I wouldn't say flavor or scent, but you know what I mean. It comes in honey, green tea, ginseng, rose, lotus and pearl, and for $20 to be able to try all of those 6 sleeping masks, I think is an excellent opportunity that I should take advantage of. The next one is another Sephora brand. This is not really on the top of my list. It's the Skin Perfect CC Cream SPF 20, and if I'm being honest with you, the only reason that that's here is because it's on sale for $11, which after the 20% off would come down to $8.8. Now, these come in 4 colors. There is the fair, which is pink toned. There is tan, which is neutral. There is dark, which is yellow toned. And then there is deep, which is more pink toned. So I don't know if I'm going to go with tanned or with dark, or if I'm going to go for it at all. But I do like myself some CC cream because there are days when you don't really want to have a full face of makeup on. Okay. Next is still Sephora, and this is their Power Couples Mani Pedi Duos. And it actually comes with 19 mini bottles of the Formula X. There's this duo, and then there's this duo, then there's this duo, and then there's this duo. But it also comes with their base coat, their top coat, and their nail cleanser, which I thought was an excellent idea for $39.50. I don't really go through nail polish, full-size nail polish anyway, so I don't really mind having the mini ones. But I'm still thinking about that because that might be a little heavy, and my sisters is doing me a favor by bringing in my orders to the Philippines when I see her for Christmas. So I don't know if I'm going to go through with that. The next thing is probably at the bottom of my priority list, and this is the NARS Dual Intensity Blush, because it's $45. And I don't know if I want to spend even $36 for a blush. This particular color that is shown here, I believe, is called Fervor. And I don't know, because I was not impressed with the dual intensity eyeshadows. I felt that it was a metallic shade that you can either use wet or dry, which is something that you can do with all of your other metallic shades by foiling them. So I wasn't very impressed with that, and for the price, I didn't think it was worth it. So I don't know if I'm going to get this if the formula is very similar to the eyeshadow. $36 isn't really something that I would spend on a blush. Now, one thing that I did get that I didn't wait for the Sephora VIB for is the Makeup Forever 15 Artist Shadow Palette. I've been wanting to get the MAC 15 shadow palettes that's pre-designed. There's one in particular on the Nordstrom site that I wanted to get, but I took a pass on it. Those ones are $85. This is $59. And a single shadow, full size, of Makeup Forever 0.08 ounces for $21. This is 0.06 ounces. And it's only $59 for the whole palette. So if you're going to buy this individually in full size, it's going to cost you about $221 in value. Oh, this is $221 in value. If you buy the 15 individual palettes, it's going to take you to $315. So I think this is an excellent value. The next thing is the Urban Decay All Nighter Long Lasting Makeup Spray Duo. I do have one of this already, and I love it because I have oily skin, because I live in a humid country, and this helps my makeup to stay on. One bottle of this is $30, so you're essentially getting the second bottle for 70% off, which is better than your buy one, get one 50% off anywhere else. Also, after the 20% off, this actually comes down to just about $1.20. That's a pretty good deal, in my opinion. Okay, the next thing here is the Laura Mercier Matte to Matte Caviar Stick Eye Color Collection. And again, this is something that is at the bottom of my my priority list, simply because I feel that they came out with something like this last year, and they would probably pretty much come out with something like this next year. And I do have some eyeshadow sticks from Makeup Forever and Tarte that are very similar to the shades that are included in this kit that I haven't made full use of. So I don't know if I want this just for the sake of having it. Especially since I can pretty much reproduce the eye looks that I can make with this with my existing eyeshadow sticks. So $58 just to have it, I don't know, probably gonna pass that, but we will see. Okay. Next thing on here is the First Aid Beauty Eye Duty Triple Remedy Brighten, Depuff, and Smooth. Now this is a $36 eye sort of primer and under eye brightener that I'm not sure I want to get, but I really have heard so many good things about it from other YouTubers that it's really tempting me. Now, the color that is shown here is the original color. There's another color called medium/deep, which is a little too dark for my NC35 skin. So I'm looking at possibly getting this. However, I'm not yet convinced. I am a fan of the First Aid Beauty skincare though, so I don't know, a 50-50 chance. Now, this Marc Jacobs Beauty, the Sophia 5-Piece Petite Le Marc Lip Cream Collection for $45 is also a very tempting offer. This is a travel-sized 5-piece set, and they're very pretty, I have to say. Very, very pretty. Look at those colors. But I don't know if I want to get one because I got last year's Urban Decay Revolutionary Lipstick or Revolution Lipstick stash, and I still have those, and I do have a lot of lip products that are already here or are on the way, so I don't know if I want to spend $45 for that, especially since that makes each of this lipstick about $9, and you can get a full size lipstick of the same shade from the drugstore probably even cheaper than $9. So I don't know, and plus I wasn't impressed with the Skyliner 7-piece petite set that they came out with last year, so I don't know if I want to spend $45 just to have the Marc Jacobs brand in my stash. I don't know. If I'm being realistic, probably not gonna buy that. Okay, the next thing is the Sephora Favorites Lash Stash, which is also a $45 value. This I didn't wait for. I got this before the VIB sale. It's already actually in my sister's house waiting for her to bring it over to the Philippines. And what's inside there, and the reason why I bought it, is there are so many of these mascaras that I have never tried before. I have never tried the Best in Full Fiber Extension from Tarte. I've never tried any YSL mascara. I've never tried, in particular, this Makeup Forever Smoky Extravagant. I've tried the Smoky, but not the Smoky Extravagant. I've never tried the Roller Lash. I've tried the Buxom, and I love it. I haven't tried any Marc Jacobs mascara. I've heard so many great things about the Too Faced Better Than Sex, and people call it their holy grail, so I really want to give that a go. This is an Hourglass 1.5mm mechanical gel eyeliner. And that is pretty expensive on its own, so I thought that would be a great way to try it. There is a Blink mascara in here as well. Never tried anything from Blink. And I'm really curious about the NARS Audacious mascara. And then there is also the Tarte Lash Curler that is just really pretty to look at. So I'm looking forward to getting this. I should have it by mid-December. And once I do, you're obviously going to get a review of it. Okay, next is also another set of products that I didn't wait for the VIB sale to happen, and I bought it already. It's the Bite Beauty Best Bite Rewind, $25 value. They come in this sort of like Altoid tin, and these are deluxe sizes of the Matte Cream Lip Crayons. They come in, what are they called? Cafe, there's Torte, there's Coolies, and there's Aubergine, and they're very beautiful ones. I took advantage of getting this already, not waiting for the sale, because I was afraid that they're going to sell out, and also because when they came out with this last year and I didn't buy it, I regretted it for a very long time, so I wasn't going to pass up on that again. Okay, two Sephora lip products that I want to try, because I'm just curious, and I haven't been disappointed by any of their lip products. I have the liquid lipstick, the matte ones. So this is the Oil Infusion Color and Care, and the other one is Rouge Infusion Lip Stain. Now I know YSL creates something similar to this, but I don't really want to pay $30 for a lip product without understanding what that is like. So maybe I'll put this two in my cart. Then I have here the Estee Lauder mascara and Pure Color Envy Lipstick Duo. This is a travel size in Envy, I think it's called. It's a beautiful true red color, and a full size of that runs for $30. And then the mascara, I think, is somewhere along the lines of $20 as well. So this is a pretty good value. I'm thinking about it, not sure about it, because I already have a few of the Color Envy lipsticks. I recently just got the Kendall Jenner Color Restless, and since I already got the Lash Stash, I don't know if I need another mascara. And then a repurchase for my favorite primer of all time. This is NARS Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Primer or Eyeshadow Base, because I've tried the Urban Decay Primer Potion. I've tried the $1 e.l.f. Primer. I've tried the Too Faced Shadow Insurance. I've tried the MAC Paint Pots, and nothing works on my super duper uber oily lids except this. So I'm definitely going to buy one for backup this year, just in case my other one runs out. All right, I'm sorry if I rushed through this whole thing, but I'm supposed to keep this under 15 minutes, otherwise I won't be able to upload it. So let me know what are the things that you would recommend I take a look at. Like this video if you liked my list. Let me know what are some of the products in the, let me know in the comment section. What is the product that you love, that you think I should look at? What are your recommendations? What are also some of the products that you think I shouldn't look at, all right? Because I also want to know what you regret and that I shouldn't spend my money on. And lastly, please subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!